we will stay here forever, you know, until we're like, you know. In fact, I've decided where I'm going to be buried. Here.
Okay.
In here. Right over here. He thinks I'm kidding.
All right, we're out here in Pennsylvania today with Weston from Tussie Landscaping, who is the head foreman and marketing guy, Steve, the owner, and Matt, the younger brother and also owner. And we are visiting all of their water features and full landscaping, because this is another one that you did, not just the water feature, but all the rest of the landscaping,
right?
Correct?
Outdoor living space.
All right, well, let's go meet these people.
Hi,
I'll give you a hug.
Oh, goody, I love huggers.
And I love Buckeye fans. You're a Buckeye fan.
Heck no.
She's like, I'm taking back that hug.
No, Penn State, baby.
We're gonna flag. So it's about 2 feet by 4 feet. All right. I'll mail you a better flag. All right, we'll say go Big Ten, since you're an aquascape lover. We'll say go Big Ten.
Wait till
so this is a newer water feature.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So when did you get it?
November.
I don't know.
Last November.
December. Was it in then?
November, December.
That's when we were doing the Logan.
So
Ball
last
thing.
Okay, December.
Yeah.
Yep. So what inspired you to get a water feature?
Derek.
Okay. So you wanted
Derek
some landscaping done.
Derek drew it up. You know, my son and I went over and talked to him and said everything that we wanted, and it was just gorgeous.
So had you thought about a water feature before? So that's really cool.
Oh well, we got really excited about everything. It's my husband, hey, Don.
Are you the big Buckeye fan here, Don?
You're out there laughing.
Yeah.
You probably didn't hear him. Right. Yeah. Nice to meet you, sir. Hey, you got us 2 years ago. We got you last year. That's a bit unusual that you weren't even thinking about a water feature, and then you just wanted some landscaping work done.
We did. We wanted an outdoor kitchen and some things, and our original thought was we would do it piecemeal.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm so glad we didn't do that. I mean, it's just drop dead gorgeous.
Okay.
We've had people over already, and they just kind of walk around going like,
they're not used to seeing something like that in a typical backyard.
No.
Yeah.
No, especially in our area.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know anybody else who has an outdoor kitchen.
Well, cool. You're hip.
I know. And we've used it a lot.
Good.
Already.
Good.
You know, yeah.
That's awesome.
Wow, this is a beautiful step place
right here.
Gorgeous work.
The railings.
My gosh. What's the membership at this country club?
That's what my daughter-in-law said too when she first saw it. She said, oh my goodness, she said, it looks like a resort.
Oh wow, yeah. Look at that. Once again, you have water-loving people. You got the swimming pool on one side and the fountainscape on the other. So unique. So Matt, explain what you did here for this project.
Okay, well, when we got here, like I said, the pool's here.
Yep.
There's a chain link fence around it. And so basically we started over. We took everything out but the pool and that little storage shed over there. We did the terracing here, put in the water feature, and then we added pavers. You know, obviously we did the pavers here. We got the pavilion over on this side with a little pool house, little dressing room and whatnot over there. And
this is quite the change.
Yeah. Oh, it's gorgeous. And we just really, we're just too happy.
So what did Derek explain to you about the water feature that got you said, okay, we'll go ahead and add that? Was it the sound? Was it the nighttime? What do you?
I don't know. We just did. We looked at the whole thing, the whole project. They gave us lots of pictures with the plan and said, does this fit in with what you were thinking about? It was so off the charts. I mean, we weren't thinking this grand.
Uh-huh.
but we're thrilled with it. Actually, what it's enabled us to do, and I hadn't thought about this before when I was filling out the paperwork.
Yeah.
One of the big things is we've decided we will stay here forever, you know, until we're like, you know. In fact, I've decided where I'm going to be buried.
Here. Okay.
In here. Right over here. He thinks I'm kidding.
I've never had this before. This is always a first. Okay.
I've had people say I see life differently than most people. I'm thinking like my urn can go right in between these two rocks and then I will always have flowers blooming.
And a water
feature
on one side.
But I still will be between a rock and a hard place.
Perfect setup. What I like to show is how people are, living the whole, you know, aquascape lifestyle, which a water feature is part of it. But you got to incorporate, you got to have a hardscape next to it, you got to have a softscape around it, so
and
the whole thing.
The area would not be the same without the water feature.
It wouldn't, it really
dead.
Wouldn't.
I mean, it adds that sound. And
it's wonderful to sit down here with the few days that we've had sun. I have been down here, and it's just nice to listen to that. You know, my daughter-in-law is studying for some testing. She comes over and sits at the bar. And
What about the water feature? How much work is that?
I haven't had any work yet.
So it's been in there for 6-7 months now. Look at the views. Look at the views here. I mean, I can see for miles and I don't see a single house. No wonder they invested all this money back in their landscape. And I love this because not only do I see beautiful properties and beautiful views like this, but cool people. She jokes that she wants to be buried here. Heck, I'd want to be buried here. Johnstown, Pennsylvania. This is our stop of the day. How are you, young lady?
I'm good.
I'm the pond guy, Greg.
Hi.
I heard that you have a beautiful property that you have done over the last 5 years in phases. A work in progress. It's a labor of love, huh?
There's that. It's been with all these wonderful people.
That is.
I feel like I'm like related to them.
That's right. You were calling this family
because they're always around and.
Pretty much.
And we're always going down to, you know, Tussie Mountain, so,
Is that where you got the inspiration for the water feature, seeing the displays that they had at the retail center?
No, I never knew about Tussie Mountains. I saw one of my friends had a pond feature done, and we thought, wow, that was really great, and thought about it for a couple of years, and then we went for it.
So how many years now have you had an aquascape water feature?
2011.
Seven?
2011
was
the first one.
Okay. Well, I'm excited to see it. Can you show us?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sure.
You got some trees blooming. What kind of tree is that?
It's a laurel, mountain laurel.
Mountain laurel.
When we cleared the trees when we built the house, we just left it there. Isn't that neat?
It is beautiful. I love the backdrop.
We have some laurel blooming kind of everywhere.
What a nice little setup you have here.
Let me turn the monster off.
Right, this is called a scarecrow and it's a motion controlled sprinkler system that when it senses motion around the water feature will nail anything that walks, including you. Right, what a cool bridge. Look at this bridge. Oh my. And I love about the bridge is it just leads you to those two chairs and that waterfalls. I mean, I don't know anybody that would be able to come out here and not walk across that bridge.
No, it's just wonderful.
Do you have a spawning?
I did. I put both two.
So you're into this hobby, huh?
Yes. I do like my koi.
So the fish spawn and then you take the
this is my first for that.
Okay.
So I'm hoping that we're going to get some fish.
Yep. It is a beautiful setting. I love your rose garden here.
Thank you.
Let me ask you, does your husband support you or are you just telling him what to do?
My husband, he loves gardening too.
Oh, nice.
And we come out here every night after dinner and do stuff. After we have our coffee on the patio, watching our fish.
I love it. So what do people say that come here for the first time?
Oh, they're in awe.
They're probably surprised to see this, right?
Yes, all the delivery men and everything. They just can't believe it.
I love that.
That this is back here. If you want to see the other pond too.
Yeah, show us.
I always say that this is my husband's pond and this is my pond.
So this is an eye. So this is another Herod scare right here.
Yes, it is.
We've got a feeding ring in there for the fish so that the water doesn't go into the vault area.
Yes.
One back here.
This is
how
the first
it started.
One, right, Weston?
Yeah, right. That all started.
Weston did it.
So this started in 2011. You put this in.
Yep, the whole thing.
The drill rocks. Yeah. So you went pretty extensive for the first water feature then. And then how long did you have this water feature before you added a bigger one?
This one was just
2 years.
Not quite. It won't be 2 years
right?
So you had this for about 4 years and then you added the new one up here.
Well, first of all, we added all the other things.
The landscaping.
A lot of landscaping in between.
Right.
Patio, front, back here.
This is called living the aquascape lifestyle. A water feature encourages the rest
of
everything.
Okay, I'll tell you how that started. You know when we had that, when the people came to visit
Pontour.
The tour? Mm-hmm. Eric and I were sitting over there. And I said to Weston, I would just love to be able to sit on the patio and actually see my fish. Well,
there's an idea.
Derek said,
the spray paint's out.
Derek said, you could do that. And it went from there.
Sure.
Tell him what Bill said with the first day.
No. There's no. You can know. And,
so your husband said no.
Well, it was an expensive pond, say at least. And he was going to buy a new car that year. And then I had to talk him out of buying the new car.
And instead of the new car, he got a new pond.
Oh, no. He went fishing with my son in Montana. And they came home, and he was in a really good mood from fishing.
Ah.
So, and then he said yes.
How many years have you been married?
It's going on 52.
And this is the secret to 52 years. You pop these things on your husband after a fishing trip.
There you go.
That's true.
There you go.
It does
and then,
work
But
way.
Then he backtracked then after we were here and we dug the hole. Oh. Remember that?
He came home after, it looked like it was just a hole. He came home and he said, oh, Carol, what have we done?
Yeah, I remember that.
The only time that we ever have an issue with the customers is during the construction, because afterwards, obviously, it turns out well.
And I said, you know, you have to trust it. You know they do wonderful work. And you know it's going to work out.
And right, you were. It is absolutely gorgeous.
And now we love it.
So what was the construction of this water feature like?
So when we came in here to do this pond, this was grass in this area between the patio and that pond there. And there was these stepping stones basically leading to that pond. We pulled those up.
Yep.
Brought in a crane through here, it was super tight access. We had to swing that boom to the backs. All the boulders were picked up 20 yards away over there.
Uh-huh.
They were all swung in here, and we placed this in here. And then when we got these key boulders in for this bridge, we actually cut into them, notched them out, laid this aluminum frame in for the bridge, and then laid our pavers right across it.
So you've done this before. This is part of one of your things I've seen.
Yeah, we have actually at least one of the other ponds we're going to has this.
So it's a lot of big boulders. I mean, I love some of the rock work. I mean, this cave right here, that fish cave, I mean, that is a gorgeous rock.
Yeah.
You know, they have a feeding ring in here because talk about your skim cove over here. So you designed it with a skim cove. What kind of pumps did you put in this?
It's a 9PL.
So it's a 9PL pump that sits down there, right in the snorkel. all the debris gets there, and then they basically just have to net it out.
Yep, and it's actually, these big ponds stay cleaner than the smaller ones, man, seriously.
The bigger the body of water, the easier it is to maintain, because it's a large, people think if they have a 10-gallon fish tank, it's a lot of work. A 100-gallon fish tank is less than a 10-gallon. Well, a 3,000-gallon pond is going to be less maintenance than a 1,000-gallon pond or a 500. Yep. Absolutely beautiful. Great work here, buddy. So kind of a unique design with a biofalse hidden and then a pretty large bubbling boulder that you kind of designed with the driftwood in here. That's a pretty neat system.
Yep. They just basically had a puddle in here before, and we came in and basically this was the footprint of the original pond that they had in here. We redid that for them, but they wanted to do something really special and something they could see more from their kitchen window. So we added this bubbling boulder setup here.
So this was first, the rock came second.
It was all done at the same time.
Okay. Yeah.
When we first came here, that's what they wanted. They wanted something that was more visual from the house, and that's what we gave them. They gave them some extra height, some extra white splashing water, and it's a pretty cool, interesting piece that kind of is unique. It's not very many ponds that have something like that on the side of it.
Very cool. Awesome. Hey, if you like what you see, like, comment, subscribe, and follow along as we visit cool contractors with even cooler customers. Carol, thank you for the hospitality.